All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Michael Bennett. He is the CEO of Altamira Gold. And Michael, it's good to have you back again. How are you?
I'm fine. Thanks very much, Steve. Great to be with you again.
Yeah, so a news release out this morning talking about your first three drill holes in the Santa Helena Project. Maybe just remind everyone a little bit about that project just before we get into what you saw today.
Yeah, it's a project which we first claimed in 2014, Steve. We had heavy competition from Codelco, the Chilean copper company, to be able to get awarded this area in 2018. And we really have been concentrating largely on the high-grade gold veins for the first part of our exploration on this area. But we were lucky enough in 2021, at the end of the year, to get a drill rig. And we decided to put the first holes into what we believed could be a porphyry source, a porphyry copper source, in an area called the Gabriel pit. And these first three holes, lo and behold, we've used two consultants, two very well-known consultants. That's Alan Wilson and Darren Jones, who are both porphyry experts, have had a lot of success in South America. And they've confirmed to us that the first three holes have porphyry alteration. And as you can see by the photos that we put in the press release, they also have porphyry mineralization, where you can see the pyrite and the molybdenite in several of those photos. And so, you know, if I look at those photos and I show the general public what's important there. So in a porphyry system, this red rock, this deep red alteration that is seen there in most of the photos is very, very characteristic of porphyry systems and of alkalic porphyry systems. And also the stockwork, which we can see in there, and these aplitic dikes with the porphyritic texture is also very, very encouraging for us in our exploration so far. So we could have hit absolutely nothing, but we haven't. We've hit the right rock type. And obviously in an area which is 10 kilometers by four, we know we need to hone down the area to continue our drill program. And that's what we will be doing in the next couple of months. We have a company, we bought ourselves our own drone and magnetometer, and we'll be flying the whole of that area to try and get a better handle on where we can properly use our next drill meters.
Yeah. Michael, what's the significance of this for your project in relation to what others have seen in their projects? There's some signs here that you're really happy you're seeing.
Yeah, well, so if we look at the structural map that I've put in the press release there, we're 60 kilometers to the southwest of the Jacka porphyry, copper porphyry find, which was made by Anglo-American in 2017. We're on what seems to be the same sort of structure. We've called it the Santa Helena Shear Zone. It's a northeast-southwest structure which runs through the area is obviously a large crustal breakage. And Jack is on one side of it and we are on the other. And I think if the general public look at that image that we put in there, you can see also the amount of structures in our Santa Helena area, which are very, very important for breaking up the rock and for the emplacement of mineralization, both copper and gold. And, you know, not to belittle molybdenum, you know, we've seen molybdenum both in the core. We have large areas of copper in soils. And so if you think about the alteration depth that we have in this area, one of our holes showed a saprolitic alteration down to plus 60 meters depth. And that is very, very significant when you look at the copper in soils. Normally in this environment, the copper would have been completely leached out. But we have, Steve, up to 300 ppm in soils. And over wide areas, we have a circular copper anomaly, which we haven't touched yet in terms of drilling, which is over 1.5 kilometers in circumference. And we obviously need to home in better to get these better targets now and to look for the center of our system.
All right. Well, we'll leave it there. You've said it. You've said it all, Michael. Well done. And you've covered off everyone, including those folks who love molybdenum. So you've got it all. Thank you, my friend. Great to see you again. And we'll check back in with you real soon.
Thanks very much, Steve. Great to be with you as usual.
All right. There's Michael Bennett, the CEO of Altamira Gold.